I can't vote for the amendment, Mr. Lincoln.
I saw a barge once, Mr. Yeaman, filled with colored men in chains, heading down the Mississippi to the New Orleans slave market. It sickened me. And more than that, it brought a shadow down, a pall around my eyes. Slavery troubled me as long as I can remember. In a way, it never troubled my father, though he hated it in his own fashion. He knew no smallholding dirt farmer could compete with slave plantations, and he took us out from Kentucky to get away from him. He wanted Indiana kept free. He wasn't a kind man, but there was a rough moral urge for fairness, for freedom in him. I learned that from him, I suppose, if little else from him. We didn't care for one another, Mr. Yeaman.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
Loving kindness, that most ordinary thing came to me from other sources. I'm grateful for that.
I hate it too, sir. Slavery, but we're entirely unready for emancipation. There's too many questions.
We're unready for peace too, ain't we? Yeah, when it comes, it'll present us with conundrums and dangers greater than any we faced during the war, bloody as it's been. We'll have to extemporize and experiment with what it is, when it is. I read your speech, George. Negroes and the vote. That's a puzzle.
No, but Negroes can't vote, Mr. Lincoln. You're not suggesting we enfranchise colored
people. I'm asking only that you disenthrall yourself from the slave powers. I'll let you know when there's an offer on my desk for surrender. There's none before us now. What's before us now, that's the vote on the 13th Amendment. It's gonna be so very close. You see what you can do.